Hello, my name is Hanna Jabbour. I'm a technical marketing engineer leader, part of TDNR. In this video, we're going to look at how Cisco XDR integrates with CrowdStrike. This video is going to focus on how this integration works. This integration now allows CrowdStrike endpoint solution to create incidents inside Cisco XDR or to contribute to incident creation inside Cisco XDR. Here we're gonna look at an example of an incident inside XDR. You can look at the name, we named it Wizard Spider. Basically, this is a simulation of Wizard Spider attack. We can look at the different tactics and techniques that are actually contributed from the integrated solution, including XDR analytics and also coming from CrowdStrike integration. When you look at the details of such information, you could see in this section, in the overview, the graph itself, nothing has changed in that. The assets, observables. Now, assets could actually come from, information could come from actual CrowdStrike contribution into the integration. In the indicator, you can see CrowdStrike, Filecoin, and being part of the indicators that contribute into the indicators inside this incident. What is the big difference is when you look at the original now detections part of an attack, you can see now CrowdStrike is part of the original source of an actual incident creation. So now they are not only investigated detections, which means before the enhanced integration, if an incident occurred, maybe based on Cisco XDR analytics, and it's investigated by the solution automatically or manually, CrowdStrike was one of the sources. Now, it's not only one of the sources of one being investigated, but it's only one of the sources that could contribute to the incident creation. So that's a big enhancement in, for this one. Moving forward and looking at the response section. In the response section, actually, CrowdStrike has been part of this from before. Just a reminder, in the containment section, you can actually contain an asset by selecting and finding the asset, because this asset has actually CrowdStrike installed on it. When you click execute, the isolation will happen on CrowdStrike. You can also use it for file hash, also blocking or IP blocking or URL blocking. So that is part of how CrowdStrike can contribute to the containment also with Cisco XDR in case you've got a CrowdStrike endpoint solution installed. One of the other ways that CrowdStrike integration contributes into Cisco XDR is when we look at investigation. So if I go into the investigate section and go ahead and launch an investigation, I'm going to launch it on a specific hash. That hash was part of the actual Wizard Spider attack. That's the first hash that actually can be seen on a Wizard Spider. Once the actual investigation is done, you could see that this information was seen inside CrowdStrike Falcon. So now CrowdStrike also Falcon contributes into investigation. That was before even the enhancements that we've got now, but just re-mentioning that this is also contributing into Cisco XDR. You could see also the relations between the different integration indicators or the different assets that are there, or observables. You can see also all the observables that are related to this that were seen on the actual device. And also you can see the process arguments that is actually available from CrowdStrike. So all this information is pulled from CrowdStrike Falcon. Other ways that CrowdStrike also contribute into Cisco XDR is it's when it comes to asset. You can integrate CrowdStrike in a way to get information about devices inside your environment. If you have multiple solutions that you can actually add different sources, of course, one of them being CrowdStrike. If we click on the devices list, this will show us the list of devices that are populated from the different sources, including CrowdStrike. In this case, we have 92 devices types. Some of them are servers, some of them are desktop, some of them are virtual. We're gonna focus on specifically, I did a top search on victim because this is one of the devices we're looking at. You could see the OS version and the source. So the source being CrowdStrike, if you click on this one specifically, it's a Windows 7. We call it victim because based on the demo itself, you could see the operating system, the local IP, the public IP, and the different information. So latest, when it was latest seen, the connection MAC address, the agent version, and also the policies applied from CrowdStrike on that specific device. So this is some of the information that we can gather using devices and using CrowdStrike as a source. So CrowdStrike contribute in multiple ways into Cisco XDR. Now we've seen how in the new enhancement we've got incident creation that comes also or contribution inside Cisco XDR analytics and Cisco XDR. Now the CrowdStrike events can contribute into incident creation. That's the first new thing. Before and still available, the ability to do investigation with data coming from CrowdStrike, also doing responses with CrowdStrike for isolating a host, a file hash, etc., and also using CrowdStrike as source of device information or asset information inside an environment. So those are the different ways that CrowdStrike contribute into Cisco XDR. Few things to note about the Cisco XDR and CrowdStrike integration. First is not every detection in CrowdStrike will lead to an XDR incident. This is an expected behavior, how actually XDR works, because not every detection from an EDR solution or an NDR solution will immediately create an incident inside Cisco XDR. Otherwise, we're stuck in the same situation of noise coming from all these solutions. Second thing is data processing lifecycle, disassemble and reassemble the data of a detection inside CrowdStrike to an incident inside Cisco XDR. That means that the actual data has changed formatting perspective, but we are not losing information about the detection itself. The third thing is to note is the time to process. Between the data is being collected, disassembled, stored, analyzed, and then actually correlated through attack chains with other detection, that means there is some time lag between the CrowdStrike detection and an actual incident creation, if there is any to be created by Cisco XDR. So those are the few things to note about the integration and how it works. Hopefully this video has been informative for you guys, and thanks for listening.